In this video, you will see how a disc brake system works in an automobile. So before going on to the disc brake system, let us first try to understand the basic working principle of a braking system. Generally, how the braking system is applied or how it works on. So the main basic working principle is the Pascal's law in the case of a disc brake system. And in Pascal's law, we know that if we have a fluid that is contained within a container, then if we apply the pressure anywhere in a contained fluid, this pressure is equally applied in all directions throughout the fluid. So if we apply pressure in one direction, it is equally distributed in all directions. That is what the Pascal's law states. And this is exactly what is the principle that is making or made use of in the case of a braking system. So here we are considering two cylinder piston arrangements which are connected with each other and they are filled with a fluid or incompressible fluid. One of the piston is smaller in size. You can see that the piston cylinder arrangement on the left hand side is smaller in size, and the piston and cylinder arrangement on the right hand side has a larger area. Now, according to the Pascal's law, let us assume that the force applied on the left piston is F1 and the force that is received at the right piston is F2. If P1 is the pressure that is developed at the piston 1 and P2 is the pressure developed at the piston 2, A1 is the area of cross section at the cylinder 1 and A2 is the cross sectional area of cylinder 2. So according to Pascal's law, if we apply pressure at the first piston, equal pressure should be developed at the second piston. We know that pressure is force by area. So in the case of first piston, we can write P1 is F1 by A1 and for P2 it is F2 by A2. Since P1, that is the pressure at the piston 1, is equal to the pressure developed at the piston 2, we can write F1 by A1 is equal to F2 by A2. And if we rearrange the terms, we can see that the force, received force F2, is given by the ratio A2 by A1 into F1. So this means that even if we are applying a smaller force at the smaller piston 1, we can receive a larger amplified force at the piston, larger piston F2. So this is the application of Pascal's law, and the same principle is applied in the case of a disc brake system also. So the smaller piston will be used as the pedal side and the larger piston will be used at the braking side. So even a small force applied at the piston 1 can result in a larger braking force at the piston side F2. So here you can see the animation where we are applying the brake pedal and it forces the piston 1, and proportionately the piston 2 is raised up. So the pedal side is usually the smaller piston side and the wheel side is the larger piston side. Now let us see what are the different components that are involved in a disc brake system. So we have the wheel hub assembly, the disc brake rotor and the brake caliper assembly, which are the main components of a disc brake. The wheel hub assembly is helping in fixing up the wheel. It is actually it helps in attaching the wheel to the hub, and the disc rotor or the rotor again is a circular disc to which the pressure of the brake pad is applied. The disc brake has two brake pads, the inner brake pad and the outer brake pad, and these two brake pads will be coming into contact with the surface of the rotor disc, and it will help in creating a friction and thereby helps in stopping the vehicle. And during friction, when the brake pads come into contact with the disc surface, as we know, during friction the heat energy is developed, or heat is developed, and this heat is dissipated or removed to the surroundings by means of providing holes. You can see certain slots or holes that are provided at the disc rotor surface, and this perforations or these holes are provided to it is actually given for ventilation, to ventilate out or give out the heat that is produced due to friction. And these are the stud holes where the stud assembly comes and is actually bolted to the surface. And here the energy conversion takes place, that is, the rotating disc rotor is brought to rest by applying brakes. So there is an energy conversion taking place, that is, kinetic energy of this disc rotor is converted into the heat energy produced by the friction during braking, and this heat is dissipated through the holes by ventilation. Then we have the caliper assembly, and in caliper assembly we have the inner brake pad and the outer brake pad, and the inner brake pad is moved by means of a piston that is located inside the brake caliper assembly. So you can see in the animation, this is a exploded view of the brake caliper assembly. You can see the different parts. We have the caliper bracket, slider pins, and the dust boots which help in preventing the dust to enter. You have the inner brake pad and the outer brake pad, and this is the caliper frame, and inside the caliper frame we have the piston that is located. So when the oil or the brake fluid flows from the reservoir, again we have certain parts. The oil is forced into the caliper frame, and due to the oil pressure, the brake fluid pressure, you can see, due to the brake fluid pressure, it will force the piston in or out, and this piston, it will come into contact with the inner brake pad, and it will help in movement of the inner brake pad, and this inner brake pad will come and contact with the disc rotor. And when the rotor brake pad comes into contact with the disc, rotating disc, and when the pressure builds up, this frame, caliper frame, is again has the provision to move to and fro within a certain limit. So when the pressure builds up, the caliper frame slightly moves towards the right hand side, and when it moves, the outer brake pad will come into contact with the rotating disc. So we can just see the animation. Now the disc is rotating. This disc is attached to the wheel. So when the hydraulic fluid or the brake fluid is entering into the caliper frame from the master cylinder, this brake fluid will exert pressure on the piston that is located inside the caliper assembly, the caliper frame. The piston will push the inner brake pad against the rotor, and due to the pressure, the caliper frame slightly moves towards the right hand side. You can see in the animation, the brake fluid is exerting pressure on the piston, and the piston moves the brake pad to the surface of the rotor, and you can see that when the caliper frame moves to the right hand side, the outer brake pad is coming into contact with the disc rotor and applies pressure. So the inner brake pad and the outer brake pad will be exerting pressure on the rotor disc, and it will help in braking of the, or it will help in stopping the disc rotor. Since the disc rotor is attached to the wheel, it will help in stopping the vehicle. So here the energy conversion taking place is that the kinetic energy of the rotor is converted into heat energy, and heat energy which is produced by the friction between the brake pad and the rotating disc, that heat energy is released to the surroundings. So this is the working principle of a disc brake system.